Hello everyone, and today my topic is disease. It's spelled as dis-ease, and it is we'll be discussing on mental, physical and emotional, and these are my contact IDs. It is there at the end also, but you can note it down. It's here also, and my new email address is mentioned, and this is my website. So before we start, let's just do a short gratitude prayer. I have written here with gratitude. So let's do a short gratitude prayer. I mean, whatever we have got in our life and whatever we'll get in our life, if we express a lot of gratitude and thanksgiving, we ignite our light. So whatever we have got, I've got this beautiful platform, I have got this beautiful people who come and watch the lectures, or all of you who watch these lectures. And I would like to express a lot of gratitude and a lot of thanks to all of you. Thank you very much for watching, and let's also express gratitude to our life, to whatever we have got and whatever we'll get in present, past and future. All of it, let's do a small gratitude prayer. I'm very thankful and grateful to all that we have received in our life and all that we'll receive in our life. I'm very thankful and grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. If we do these prayers more again, is what happens is our consciousness starts raising up. We don't see problems as problems, but we see as something that, okay, I've been offered this, let me look at the best part of it. Mujhe problems aa rahe hai, lekin main iska best solution kaise nikalu, ya best tarike se main isko handle kaise karu. Like when we are working in a corporate jobs and when we are given a project, ya hame kuch achieve karna hai, hamara business goal, we always look at the positive parts. We will always see that hum isko kaise behtar bana sakte ya behtar tarike se achieve kar sakte. So today my discussion will be on disease, and I wanted to start with gratitude. So we've already done the gratitude, so let's start with our topic. I'll be covering on the mental, physical and emotional, but before we start, let's look at the disease. Now here I've covered the disease. So what is a disease? Basically disease, it's a manifested element that either we are having and some form of illness which is there in our body, which is either acute, which is very mild, or which is chronic. Chronic means it will keep repeating again and again. And there can be any triggers. It can be through food, it can be through environment. Food ki wajah se bhi ho sakta hai, environment ya aapke mental patterns ya emotional patterns ki wajah se bhi ho sakta hai. So basically hum energy ke bare mein baat karte hai, to ye hai, it's a disturbance of human energy, okay? And my topic today, I have just you know, little bit twisted it as dis-ease, means it's a lack of ease, means it's I don't feel comfortable, I don't feel the harmony. Kahan pe harmony aur ease nahi hai? Body and mind, because body and mind synchronistically connected. Mind is connected with the body, body is connected with the mind, both vice versa, okay? So dis-ease means a lack of ease or harmony within the body and the mind. And we will be exploring through the mental, physical and emotional. Mental means the mind, physical means the body or the matter, and emotions means it's a form of energy. Now emotions can be good and bad, and it would be stored. So let's explore. First is the mental. Mental means see, means whatever I am seeing. I will be covering this part detailed in the upcoming slides. So we are just, I have categorized this of what I feel, and I'm very thankful. Again, I'm expressing gratitude. I started my lectures here since 2014, and since I've been giving here, I have also grown. So all my future lectures that will be come will be all upgraded parts. This may have covered earlier, but this is something when I upgrade as a soul or I upgrade as a consciousness, I'll always be giving it. So mental is see, I see the world. Hum dekhte hai, perceptions banate hai, I see. Five sensory yane hum dekhna, soongna, mehsoos karna. Jo bolte na, five ways of analyzing things. So these are called as a five senses. So how do I categorize as mental? Mental means I will be like a very active mind, that is called as a conscious mind. Through the conscious mind, I will build a lot of perceptions. Now perceptions, if there are good, it's good, nice. But they are bad, then it's becoming a pattern, and this pattern is becoming a part of my Achetan Man. Achetan Man ko hum English mein kya bolte hai? Subconscious mind. Okay? And it also collects the data, yani continuously hum jo bhi cheeze dekhte hai din mein hum कंटिन्यूसली उसका डेटा कलेक्ट करते रहते हैं किस फॉर्म में, एनर्जी के फॉर्म में. अगर हमने अच्छा डेटा देखा है पूरे दिन में, अच्छी इमेजेस देखी है, तो एक अच्छा फाइल डाउनलोड होगा. लेकिन उसी समय पे हमने स्ट्रेस देखा है या यू नो सम नेगेटिविटी देखी है, तो वो अगर हमारा माइंड का इंटरनल एनर्जी स्ट्रांग नहीं है तो वो एक नेगेटिव मेमोरी भी क्रिएट करेगा. सो डेटा फॉर द माइंड इट विल कीप कलेक्टिंग. यानी उसका काम क्या है, कैमरा के जैसे कैप्चर करना है. ये कोई जजमेंटल नहीं है, ये बस कैप्चर करेगा. अभी हमें सोचना है हमें क्या कैप्चर करना है, हमें हमारे अंदर क्या स्टोर करना है या नहीं करना है. बिकॉज वी डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू बी इन दिस ईज विद द माइंड एंड द बॉडी बोथ, राइट. सो नाउ दिस विल ऑल्सो, फाइव सेंसेस विल ऑल्सो प्ले अ पार्ट फॉर दैट. एंड स्टोरेज ऑफ इमोशंस, कि पहले ही इमोशंस अंदर भरे पड़े हैं. कई बार प्रॉब्लम कुछ नहीं होता है, लेकिन अंदरूनी इमोशंस जो है वो बहुत होते हैं. अब ये अंदरूनी इमोशंस कई बार हमें पता ही नहीं होते, जिसको हम बोलते हैं अनकॉन्शियस माइंड. टुडे अनकॉन्शियस माइंड इज़ वाइडली नोन, बट अ कपल ऑफ ईयर बैक अनकॉन्शियस माइंड वॉज नॉट नोन. इन आई वुड गिव द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अनकॉन्शियस माइंड बाय कार्ल जंग. सो यू कैन गूगल एंड यू कैन फाइंड. And I have also done lectures on unconscious mind. So unconscious mind, it's like a storage jo hamare soul se connected hai. So there are storage of emotions already in the mind consciousness. Agar hume isko tackle karna hai, to hume constitutional based therapy karna chahiye. Constitutional based therapy Ayurveda mein aur homeopathic mein hoti hai, jahan pe hum pura patient ka case history lete hai, what events have happened and what is क्या इवेंट्स के वजह से जो उसके लाइफ में जो चीज़ें हो रही है वो ट्रिगर कर रही है. सो इफ़ यू फाइंड द रूट कॉज, द माइंड एंड द बॉडी विल स्टार्ट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ इटसेल्फ. सो इट्स अ कंटिन्यूस साइकिल दैट वी इटसेल्फ आर बिल्डिंग, एंड समवेयर वी गेट स्टक इन दैट साइकिल. सो अनकॉन्शियस माइंड कैन बी हैंडल इन दैट वेज. यस, देर आर मेनी हीलिंग थेरेपीज, वील कम टू दैट. एंड अनहेल्दी हैबिट्स, यानी वो हैबिट्स जो हम लगातार करते जा रहे हैं, इट कैन बी कैटेगराइज एज बैड हैबिट्स. यानी जो जैसे ही इन द मॉर्निंग वी टेक अ न्यूज़पेपर एंड वी आर कंटिन्यूसली रीडिंग द नेगेटिव न्यूज़, इफ़ वी आर रीडिंग समथिंग दैट इज़ गोइंग टू अपग्रेड आर माइंड, एंड इफ़ वी आर रीडिंग समथिंग दैट इज़ गोइंग टू गिव अ ब्यूटिफुल जस्टिफिकेशन टू द माइंड, और इट इज़ हेल्पिंग टू एक्सपांड आर माइंड कॉन्शियसनेस, देन गुड. बट इफ़ दैट्स गोइंग टू एड ऑलरेडी नेगेटिविटी है और हम और डाल रहे हैं, सो यू आर मेकिंग इट एज अ पैटर्न. पैटर्न्स को हैबिट में बनने में टाइम नहीं लगता है. अगर हमारा माइंड का रिजिडिटी बहुत ज़्यादा है तो वो जल्दी एक पैटर्न बन जाता है. ओके, सो द मेंटल का परसेप्शन हम अनहेल्दी हैबिट्स में डाल सकते हैं, बैड हैबिट्स, रिजिड पैटर्न. जैसे अभी मैंने कहा कि रिजिड पैटर्न्स, ईगो, स्टबर्ननेस, अनफ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट आर बिहेवियर टू अदर्स, बट आई एम टॉकिंग आर बिहेवियर टू आर ओन सेल्फ. एंड दीज ऑल दीज इमोशंस विल बी स्टोर्ड इन द बॉडी. आई विल कम इन द अपकमिंग स्लाइड्स कि ये कहाँ जाएगा. ओके, ये हम ही अपने साथ इतनी रिजिडिटी बनाते हैं. सो देन वी बिकम वेरी अनफ्लेक्सिबल इन एक्सेप्टिंग चेंजेस इन लाइफ. व्हाई पीपल कैन नॉट एक्सेप्ट चेंजेस इन लाइफ, बिकॉज अ माइंड हैज़ मेड अ रिजिड पैटर्न इन साइड. जो मैंने कहा कि कॉन्शियस माइंड इज़ लाइक अ प्रोजेक्टर. आई हैव इमेजेस, ये बहुत क्लियर हो जाएगा व्हेन यू सी दैट इमेज. एंड एनवायरमेंटल डिस्टर्बेंसेज, यानी हम जिस सोसाइटी में है या विच सोसाइटी वी आर ब्रॉट अप एंड व्हाट इज़ अराउंड अस विल ऑल्सो क्रिएट अ पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव इफेक्ट. सो दिस इज़ हाउ द परसेप्शंस विल स्टार्ट बिल्डिंग इन द कॉन्शियस माइंड. ओके, इट विल स्टार्ट कल्चरिंग इन साइड. एंड सोशल डिसकल्चरिंग, यानी यू नो it said that if we don't have certain things then we will not feel complete. So somewhere our image also gets affected. So mind wo bhi store karta hai. And financial burden, lot of people have insecurities about finances, so that also can disturb your mind and that also can cause a dis-ease. Okay, then now how, मीन्स आई मे हैव गॉट दीज पैटर्न्स थ्रू माई सोल, यू नो इट्स समवेयर बहुत डीप 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 है, मुझे भी पता नहीं है क्या है. यू नो unconscious mind is a part of my mind where I've not explored it. It's there with everyone. So when we come from journeys to journeys, our soul remains the same. We are taking a new body. That means I'm carrying it already. वो तो एक पैटर्न बन जाती है ना, मतलब एक वो कंटिन्यूस, जैसे कॉन्शियस माइंड एक कैमरा के जैसा है, वो स्टोर कर रहा है, उसको पता नहीं है अच्छा क्या है बुरा क्या है. मेरा माइंड अगर उसको सोचेगा, कौन सा लेवल का माइंड, सबकॉन्शियस लेवल का माइंड, अगर वो उसे सोचेगा तो वो उसको छाटेगा, फिल्टर डालेगा कि ये अच्छा नहीं है, इसको निकाल दो, ये अच्छा है इसकी वाइब्रेशन ले लो, ये वाइब्रेशन बहुत डल है इसकी वाइब्रेशन को निकाल दो. अब ये तभी होगा जब आप अंदर झांकेंगे, एंड देन यू विल लिसन, यू विल ब्रीथ, ओके, यू विल क्लोज योर आइज, यू विल नोटिस, यू विल पॉज, यू विल अलाउ योर सेल्फ टू एम्ब्रेस एंड एक्सेप्ट. दैट मीन्स हाउ कैन दिस हैपन, वी कैन हैव दिस कैन हैपन बाय मेडिटेशन. सो मेडिटेशन इज अ सिंपल वे वेयर वी कैन ऑब्जर्व. आप जब मेडिटेट करते हैं तो बहुत सारे थॉट्स आते हैं. सो व्हाई इट इज़, बिकॉज आर माइंड इज़ हैविंग ऑल दैट एनर्जी ऑफ ऑल दोज कन्फ्यूज थॉट्स. बट वेन यू रेगुलरली स्टार्ट मेडिटेटिंग, इवन 5 मिनट्स अ डे और 10 मिनट्स अ डे, स्लोली आर माइंड स्टार्ट्स कल्चरिंग एंड स्टार्ट्स गेट्स यूज टू लिसनिंग योर ओन सेल्फ. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हमारे माइंड में इतना कुछ चल रहा है, हम अपने अंदर की आवाज़ सुनेंगे कैसे, क्योंकि बाहर ऑलरेडी बहुत सारा जो बोलते हैं ना, नॉइज़ पोल्यूशन इज गोइंग ऑन, बिकॉज अ लॉट ऑफ पैटर्न्स इन आर लाइफ आर बिल्ड अप इन दैट वे. सो व्हेन वी स्टार्ट मेडिटेटिंग एंड व्हेन वी स्टार्ट रेगुलरली मेडिटेटिंग एवरी डे, वी स्टार्ट लिसनिंग टू आर ओन सेल्फ, एंड दैट्स द फर्स्ट स्टेप वेयर वी विल स्टार्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग आर ओन सेल्फ. दैट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. इफ़ वी डू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड आर ओन सेल्फ, हाउ कैन वी हील आर सेल्फ. ओके, and there is a beautiful saying by Dalai Lama, when you talk you're only repeating what you already know, but if you listen you may learn something new. Listen to what? Inner voice. Inner voice is connected to whom? God, divine. जब वो एक saying है ना, हम अपनी अंदर की बात सुनते हैं तो वो परमात्मा की ही कही हुई बात होती है. इट्स समवन, गॉड सेज, वेयर इज गॉड रिसाइड्स, गॉड रिसाइड्स इन एवरी वन ऑफ अस. सो व्हेन वी लिसन टू अस, वी आर लिसनिंग आवर इनर वॉइस विच द डिवाइन इज कम्युनिकेटिंग. दिस स्लाइड विल कम, आई विल कवर अप दैट. नाउ वी कवर द इमोशनल पार्ट, द सेकेंड एस्पेक्ट, द मेंटल, इमोशनल एंड द फिजिकल. So emotion is all about feeling and experiencing. Again, this is connected with our 5 senses, how we see, how we feel, how we touch, all that will be connected. Again, addictions to unhealthy patterns like having junk food, spending time or doing and reading things that create a lot of negative patterns in us. So these emotions are creating a wrong kind of memory inside us. That is disturbance of emotions of the right and the left side. It is said the right side of the brain controls the left side of the body. Left side of the brain controls the right side of the body. Left side is all about analyticals and right side is all about creativity. But we cannot be over analytical and there has to be somewhere a balance. Over creative, but we are not over analytical. So how will be balance? In a business, you need to be analytical also and you need to be creative also. Some business will require a proportion of more analytical because there's a lot of calculations going on, but some business will require more of creativity. Ideally, there has to be a balance between right and left side, and that's where you will create solutions all of out of nothing. And that's why a lot of some entrepreneurial businesses become very successful, because they can balance both the aspects, the analytical part, that is a business aspect, and also the creative aspect. Okay, so that's the emotional part. Then absorbing overtly qualities, yani over compassionate is also not being a good quality. You can easily absorb other people's energy which can be stored, and which, I mean, aapka kuch bhi nahi hai, but you're absorbing, you're becoming like sponges, and if your internal auric field is very weak, you absorb other people's energy. Over compassionate, over judgmental, yeah, over greedy, or over angry, either you're creating that in your aura, or either you're being too over compassionate, you're pulling someone's energy. Because all we are made up of energy, frequency and vibrations. So when we talk with someone, or when someone thinks about us, we connect through energy. So it's very important to have a very good aura. Meditation helps a lot in having a very good aura. And again, all that emotions that you're going to build by these habits are going to create your chakras. Chakras are nothing but, in simplified forms, is energy centers which are storing various forms of consciousness. Even though people have higher consciousness, many a time their lower chakras are disturbed. But still, even their lower chakras are disturbed, their higher consciousness will not be disturbed, because it will flow. Okay, so chakra imbalance is nothing but an energy imbalance. We have been storing the wrong, we have been feeding the wrong food to it, and that is why there is an imbalance. Now, food and nutritional imbalance. Now, this has been happening a lot. What food is good for us, what food is not good for us, and A food can be good for you, A food may not be good for me. So what is my constitution and how does my body react to that food, and how is the nutritional aspect coming inside me, that will also affect my emotions. Okay, and if a certain amount of food I'm taking in an excess, then it is also disturbing the energy in my body. Okay, which is, if that part of my body is disturbed, then my mind also will disturb, because my stomach is paining. I keep repeating, my stomach is paining, my stomach is paining. And my mind is continuously storing that memory. My stomach is paining, my stomach is paining, my stomach is paining. So another is inadequate sleep and exercise. Now every person will have a different pattern of sleep. If you see, the children require more hours to sleep. As you start growing, you may require say around 6 to 7 hours, or maybe 7 to 8 hours. But as you start becoming towards an older state, your sleep cycles will be more. And exercise is required to keep the emotional body toned, is because exercise is nothing but the movement of energy in the body. Either you do through the gym, through the machines, or either you do through the yoga, pranayams, anyways, but it is nothing but the movement of energy in your physical body, and that's how you tone it. There are various forms of yoga. There is hatha yoga, there is power yoga, there is a basic yoga, whichever forms of exercise. This will create the movement of energy, and wherever the energy is stuck, it gets a movement. Yoga is a best form of exercise, and sedentary lifestyle. Sedentary lifestyle means very comfort zone, and getting very used to a certain lifestyle. Now that is going to disturb my body for sure, because my emotions become very rigid at that time. I get used to my certain patterns. Okay, we'll go to the next slide. Again, I said meditation is a very good formation to observe yourself. I have my workshops also which are designed on that. And again, for money, I have, again, money also causes a lot of problem, as I said, in the conscious mind, and that can disturb your body also. So these are the workshops. So the physical part, when we come, physical part is something that is connected with the matter, that's body. And body consciousness, that means how you feel about yourself, and how are your image about your own self. This all talks about your own self only. How confident you feel in your own body. Do you feel that I am not great in this body? Then you need to have that conditioning that I love my body. The moment you say I love my body and I love the way I am, your body starts releasing all those emotions that you get stuck. Like I just pointed in my the first part, the mental part, the ego, the stubbornness, where it will go. It may go in my knees, or it may go in my spine, it may go in my shoulder, where it will be. Now if I am loving my body, or if I'm loving each and every organ or each and every cell in my body, what message am I giving to my body? Love. And love has the highest vibration of energy, which can change the frequency of your body, and which in through which your body can feel heal faster, and the dis-ease, that is the dis-ease of harmony in your body, will be less. The harmony will be more, and the imbalance will be less, and lower self-esteem of self, and energy disturbance in the body, physical form. There can be energy disturbance in the body in the form of systems. We are made up of various systems, the blood system, then the skeletal system, the hormonal system, the glands. We are made up of glands. Again, glands are connected with our chakras also, hormones are there, then tissues and cells. And if we break that in a nano form, that we are made up of atoms and molecules, that is particles of energy which are stored inside us. So we won't go on the particle level right now. Maybe in my upcoming lectures I'll talk on the particle level. And low self-esteem of myself, I don't feel great about myself. A lot of people talk that people build judgments about them. I think they should stop reacting to everyone what they say. I think one should have a lot of confidence and one should feel a lot of love, appreciation, courage, strength for the own self. One should never have the feelings of lack. You may not have what you're dreaming about right now, but never feel the lack, because today what you are and tomorrow what you are, it depends on what you're harboring inside you. It's not because someone is making a perception about you. So do not have the feelings of lack. First of all, about your own self, feel great about your own self, that you've been given this opportunity to express yourself through this life. And body diseases, physical, since it's a physical and a matter form, either you are experiencing in an acute, chronic, in a mild way, and structural, it can be spinal or any bone diseases, and experiencing either either you're experiencing a pain, a small form of pain, either it's little mild or it is unbearable. So it can be anything. And again, negative patterns for the state of health. Now there are a lot of people who say that I'm continuously experiencing this pain. I'm continuously, the pain can be mild. It can be a mild pain, but the way that you are building it inside your mind and you're culturing in your mind, this mild can increase, because you're keeping your vibration in the mind that my pain is there, my pain is there, my pain is there. Instead, if we change the dialogue of the mind, I am causing more harmony and less of disharmony. Again, sedentary lifestyle is also becoming a part and of most people's life, in a too much comfort zone. So somewhere the balance is required. Some may not be able to do all what I can do or you can do, but a comfort zone somewhere, it will require a balance and less or inadequate of sleep. And exercise, again I'm repeating that part here also, because physical body will require that form, and for physical movement of the body to keep it in harmony. The purpose of doing an exercise will be to keep the body in harmony. Okay, let's see the another slides. Now what the mind, this is what I wanted to talk about, is the mind and the body system. Each system, cells and the atoms of the body is in constant communication with each other. That means there's a constant Wi-Fi connection going on. We don't see that, but it's happening. So if I am telling my mind that, oh, I'm sick. I mean, I can give an example that yesterday my voice was not opening up at all. I've been continuously speaking. So my voice had gone dead in the night. I only knew that today I have to give a lecture and I'll be healed in the morning. I trusted first my ability that I have, that I can heal myself, and I also trust the divine's ability that the divine will heal me. Okay, so my mind and body is communicating, and when I get up in the morning, I do not have any pain, I do not have any discomfort, my voice is quite open, though my toning of the voice will be a little different because I may have cold and all that, but my voice is totally open. I do not have any pain, I do not have any discomfort. So who healed me? First, my acceptance has 90% healed me, and obviously the divine angelic support of the divine masters who have healed me. So my communication, basically what I want to point out is, I am saying that my body heals quickly and easily. What I cultured in the mind is, my body will heal quickly and easily. I'm not telling my mind that no, my throat problem is not going to make me talk about my throat problem. Continuously I'm culturing my mind that no. That means I'm causing more of dis-ease, and I'm causing more of disharmony in the form of energy. But at the same time, when I'm saying that, I'm very confident that when I get up in the morning, not only I'll feel good and great, but I'll have a very soothing throat. What happened was the culturing of the mind, which was connected with my mind and the body system, which healed on its own. And we need to say this, you can zoom on this part if you want. This is a very, I think it belongs to Louise Hay, and I'm very thankful and grateful to Louise Hay that she also has been my teacher, and she has beautiful affirmations, and they're all over there. And this is a very beautiful affirmation that I give to everyone. Every cell in my body, you can do it with actions, you should feel it. When we say the mental, the physical, the emotional, all three bodies will be covered. Like how children say the nursery rhymes, the same way. Every cell in my body vibrates with energy and health. Loving myself heals my life. I nourish my mind and body and soul, and my body heals quickly and easily. If we nurture our mind with these kind of vibrations and these affirmations, our mind start accepting. Because I am accepting it, that yes, I'm healing every moment. And even if you listen to Louise Hay, the way she says it is very beautiful. So I think you should culture a habit where at some time of your day, you will give for yourself whatever you want to do. You want to do meditation, you want to do healing, you want to spend your time on your goals, but it is very, very required, because indirectly or indirectly, it will also affect your mind and the body system. So everything will be connected and everything will be in a constant motion. Like each system, cell, atom of the body is in constant communication with each other. The movement is always happening. If we are continuously thinking negative, our DNAs are also replicating the same thing. So it all works on a very nano level and address the root cause. Like I said, ki constitutional based therapies are much better. Yes, Reiki works very beautiful on mind and emotions. I have created wonders with Reiki 1 where there are no symbols, but it heals people very beautifully. Obviously, I have little bit altered in my way, but it's a beautiful session of even Reiki 1 people do it. It's a very beautiful way of energizing your body, balancing your body emotions. So if you address the root cause, if you just do a constitutional base of understanding, the body can heal itself. It's very rightly said that the body will continue to heal itself as long as you provide the environment for you to heal, for it to heal. That means you have to provide all of that to heal. You have to provide the right type of emotions. That means you have to stop. You have to say no, that I refuse to take this negativity. I accept only positivity. And when you say that, our mind starts culturing only positivity. Okay. So you need to put that into the mind and address the root cause. And again, alternately, how it can be healed. Again, I'm saying that you do not have to disturb your medical treatment or anything, but alternately, these are some energy medicine techniques which can be used. For the mind, what can we do is meditation, mantras, Reiki 2 and 3. Reiki 2, level 2 and level 3 is called as a master level, can work very good. And do not jump on the level 3 before you have done the level 1 and level 2. EFT is an emotional freedom technique. It's widely used that you tap. It's I have combined that beautifully in all my healings, and it's within 10 minutes you itself can feel better. So it's a very beautiful technique. Subconscious mind healing course, that one which I have designed, and the other courses which I put in, like angelic prayers are there. This is the way I have programmed it. You may have other therapies, you can add it to it, that's good. And aura photography is a way where we understand how our energy is cultured in our physical body and the mind. Obviously, we cannot see a mind, but we can see how the energy is constructed in our auric field. So that's one good way of understanding how is the energy around us. And nature healing. Now, nature healing is a very beautiful form of healing that just takes you a few minutes or a few hours in a week or a month, but that's the fastest way anyone can heal, because Ma Prakriti has that powers that can heal anyone through the mind, body and the consciousness. And that's where your channels of awareness will also start opening up. So it's a very beautiful way of healing the mind. The example I can give is you listen to the birds chirping in the morning, how you will feel. You will feel so good. Your mind will feel so good. For that moment, you'll feel so good. So that's nothing but a nature healing, because where it's coming, right? Or if you just observe the trees, how you will feel. Okay. So that's a beautiful aspect that can heal our mind, but we need to take out time. Okay? and prayers. Prayers are the divine vibrational, I would categorize that as scientifically, what are prayers? Prayers are the way you use the words and the way you say it with the belief and faith. They are energy, modifications and not modifications, but energy vibrations which are built. So prayers always have divine words in that, and that creates that energy. When we say it with lot of faith and belief, it actually either we are doing the prayers for others or we are doing it for us. So that's also one good therapy. For the body, exercise is good. Yoga, walking is a very good exercise. It helps to ground. And meditation, again, Reiki level one works very good on the body. Smile healing, now I have made this form of healing. We'll be doing a short session on this smile healing, not a session, but 1 second meditation on this. In between I'll take it. And smile healing, I've added it as a part of my emotional healing course. And EFT, again, tapping. Mudra therapy, again, is constitutional based. Many people are doing this mudra therapy. It's based on a person's constitution, how she's thinking, how are the patterns in her life, what is the social culturing, what is her own emotional culturing, and what are the factors influencing his or her state, whatever she's taking the help for. So that's a very beautiful therapy. Again, aura photography helps us to understand that you may have some energy which is disturbed right now, but we may not know because we are not able to understand. So it can give you an indication that, you know, some part of it is in your physical body, the energy is showing very dull. So tomorrow you may experience pain, not now, because it's not yet started. Okay, and prayers also work very good for the body. For the emotional healing, forgiveness therapy is very, very important, because unless you do not release, we do not accept. Our human mind and our human body is built up on that unless we are not in the mindset to release it, a new form of energy won't come. So there are a lot of mental blocks, emotional blocks and physical blocks because of that. So forgiveness therapy helps a lot. Emotionally, I have included in my course, and Reiki 2 will help a lot for emotional healing. Reiki has certain symbols which are very good for that. Angelic prayers, again EFT meditation, Karuna healing I have added for this, and divine healing through prayers. Now this will require a little higher forms of consciousness. Mudra therapy I have added, then crystal therapy. Crystals also will work very well for the emotional state. Crystals like clear cuts, amethyst, rose quartz will work very well. These are the alternate energy medicine therapies which can be tried. Aura photography will tell your auric field, and angelic healing therapy will also work very good. Again, for the emotions, people may have a lot of rigid emotions, so inner child healing is also a new therapy which is started. So this will also help a lot. And art therapy. I don't know how many of you are aware about art therapy, but this is, it actually helps us to balance our right side of the brain. So it is a creative aspect that you may not know, but a lot of answers can come to the art therapy. So once how you're painting, what is the style of your painting, how your strokes you're putting, what colors you're putting. So that way you can diagnose the state of the person, and then from stages to stages, how his paintings show a change can also be a part of a therapy. And this also is an aspect for inner child healing. So it's a very beautiful therapy. I think very soon I'll come with this. And since I'm very creative, I always want to get some new forms of healing always. And EFT tapping. Jo hum aise karte hai na. This. It's very widely known. Yes. So we talk about energy now. When you're
unknowingly tapping?
No, there is a certain way of doing the tapping.
Unknowingly.
Not unknowingly, it's knowingly.
Knowingly, then you have to tap.
Yes. Okay. How would you tap unknowingly? We have to know for what purpose we are tapping, right? Why it is called as emotional freedom technique?
No.
EFT is where you have to acknowledge the problem first, and that's how you start the tapping. Yeah. I mean, everyone would have their own ways. I would not disturb it. Everyone would have their own creativity, but that's how I do. See, again, I say that everything is based on intention. Every healing happens on intention. So everyone would have different ways of working out. So it's very, very good to adapt new things if this is going to get better results. So it's very good to try a variety of things. But I always would do is like, I'll acknowledge what it is. There may be required many rounds of EFT. So along with EFT, I may have to give a Reiki also, because I need a more deeper healing. So I have to understand what is the requirement of a person. So when we talk about energy, energy vibrates at a frequency that is in direct alignment of the with what the universe been attempting to deliver. When the energy vibrates at a frequency that is in direct alignment with what the universe has been attempting to deliver your entire life, you begin to live in the flow and true miracles start to happen. That means, when your energy vibrates at the frequency that is in direct alignment with what the universe has been attempting to deliver to you in the entire life, you begin with the flow. That means it's a divine communication. When we are connected with that divine communication and when we are connected with that divine flow, everything in our life becomes like a miracle, because it's just a flow of life. That's what we have come to here to live. So the disharmony for the mental, physical, emotional starts reducing when we flow with the divine harmony. Okay. And now we come back to the energy source from where these are the underlying parts that I'm making you understand of how that mental, physical and emotional dis-ease can be structured into a more better and a healing process. So now how do we get the energy? There are various ways that we get energy. One is food energy, what we consume in the body. This is renewable every day. Then water energy, this is a very important form of energy, because 75% water content in the body, if this is balanced, it can cause a lot of harmony in our body. There will be less dis-ease and there will be more harmony. When there is more harmony in our body, mind also heals fast. Body also heals fast and you start feeling better. Okay, you heal fast also. And plant energy in the form of vegetable fruits, it carries various forms of nutrients or nutrition. Flower energy, we have a lot of therapies, batch flower therapies, and you know, essential oils which are being used as a therapy today. So even that is a form of energy. Now all that comes from Ma Prakriti only, and cosmic energy. As we know, there's a beautiful movie for that, spiritual reality, in where we see how the energy comes in the physical body. So cosmic energy is basically unlimited and abundant, and it requires complete consciousness to understand that. Nature's energy, like I said, spend a few moments and a few minutes with the nature, you will understand that the nature's energy, Mother Nature's energy, is so nurturing and grounding. If you walk on the bare soil, or if you walk it on the grass, you will start feeling so much relaxation because you will be grounded. Crystal energy, from crystals also we get energy. Different forms of consciousness. Now there are various crystals which are used in therapy. These are also widely known therapies now give energy. Rose quartz give a very balanced and a peaced energy. Amethyst has a beautiful spiritual energy. It can be used for manifestations of your mind. That means it can be used to reduce the dis-ease that is there in our mind. It can be used as a therapy also. And sound energy, that is, there are a lot of sound based therapies which are being used, and they are widely used all over the world, even in India, Mumbai, wherever it is being used. So this also creates a harmony, because if certain sound wave, certain wave in our body is disturbed, the sound waves will try to correct that and heal that pattern, and that will create more harmony. So the dis-ease will be less. Now that dis-ease may be on the mental level, but because of the mental level, it is connected to the body level. So this is also one form of therapy and one form of energy we get, which can be used. And this is how our body gets developed by whatever we think. Thoughts whatever we think makes our emotions that we feel, and whatever we feel, our behaviors are connected with that. So all what we think impacts our emotions, it also impacts our behaviors, and this is how we become as energy body. We were just talking about the energy, how we receive body, and we build different layers of energy inside us. It can be mixed layers of energy. Because of our thoughts, we are creating. Every moment we are creating ourselves, we are creating the energy inside hundreds and crores of cells inside us. So if we think in the right way, if we make a little bit strictness for the conscious mind that, you know, this, I'm always going to program my mind in a positive way. If you just continuously harbor that thing, then what feeds inside is a more higher vibrational state than a lower vibrational state. Okay, so these are various energy bodies which are there inside us, and as what I think, the levels of mind will be created. Like, again I repeat, this is a aware mind, that is a conscious mind. It is just absorbing the data, it is making patterns, it's a conscious mind basically. It is building sanskaras also. From the childhood we have been seeing the patterns of being grown up and addictions, whether good or bad. Unaware subconscious mind, it's only storing that energy which is being captured. Now it can be very powerful if it's cultured in a very good way, which can shape your entire future, or it can be weak. That means it has a lot of fear, it has a lot of anxiety, it has a lot of stress, or it has a lot of expectations which are burdening. And where will these emotions go? I'll show you in the upcoming slides. And this is where your memories will be connected. So when we do the therapies like tapping, or the therapies like forgiveness, what it heals is the memories here. Now this can be strong or negative or weak, and that will impact your aura. So your aura can be disturbed or aura can be strong. If your aura is disturbed, it may have some points where you can pick up anyone's energies. So another level of mind is a highlighted awareness, which we called as super consciousness. And this is connected with our soul consciousness, and becomes aware of the universal cosmic energy, regularly meditates. So we're using this level of mind, active of health and mind consciousness. He is very active of how his health is building every moment through energy and mind consciousness. And this person with a highlighted awareness will have a lot of spiritual gifts within, and this may be in the unconscious mind. Okay, right now I'm not aware, but if I start observing the data, what's going inside, if I start storing, instead of bad memories I create good memories. I always say don't create memories, create moments, because moments is what will become a memory finally. So if you are making good moments, it will become a good memory. And when I will start becoming aware and I will know what is unconsciously stored inside me, my highlighted awareness will itself make me so much realize that I can itself heal myself. Everyone has the capacity to heal his or own self, not just through the mind, through the body, but also through the soul. So whatever we will think, the mind will create that. So mind part is only to create, body part is only to reciprocate it outside. So 87 to 93% of the diseases can be contributed to our thought life. That means thoughts become emotions, because why? Thought is form of energy. Emotion is established. It can be anger, it can be envy, it can be sorrow, it can be fear, anything. And emotions become our attitude. Like if I'm used to staying very happy, and if I have happy emotions, what will be my attitude? I will be always happy. You've seen so many people, whatever problems, they're always happy, they're always smiling, because that's their attitude. Okay, and attitude becomes reaction. So that attitude becomes a part of how we would react. And slowly, if you culture this, we may not be used to culturing this, but somewhere a start is required, because if we start today, our soul will have all of this, and reactions become our lifestyle. So many of the diseases become contributed because of our thought life. So that is why there are many healing that are happening on subconscious level. If we heal the subconscious, it's very easy to be connected with your own super consciousness. Okay, and when the conscious mind expands to embrace the deeper levels of thinking, when the conscious mind is expanding to embrace the deeper levels of thinking, the thought wave becomes more powerful. That means it's constantly vibrating in a right pattern. I'm not wasting my time. It's always said time is money, but time is also consciousness. It's building you as a person every moment, and those moments are creating memory. So where am I putting my mind and where am I putting my thoughts? So rather I put my thoughts, or rather I put my mindset in something that's making me more powerful, and the results are added energy, very good energy and very good intelligence. So I utilize my mind to create an expanded and deeper levels of thinking, then I can become a powerful energy and a powerful intellectual person. Really, what is there inside me, I can express very, very easily. Because everyone has their gifts inside them. It's only we need to figure out. So now, how emotions will harm your body? I mean, this has been covered by many people. So I'll just quickly tell, like, how the it can be vice versa anywhere. So anger will weaken the liver, the grief will weaken the lungs, a lot of grief, unforgiveness, stubbornness, resentment is stored in the heart chakra, worry, it will weaken the stomach. If we bahut chinta karte hai to stomach kharab ho jata hai, pet kharab ho jata hai. Stress will weaken the heart and the brain, and the fear will weaken the kidney. So whatever we will think, that will affect our body, because we are connected through energy. So this is also one more diagram. Now, low bone density, having a lot of fears of life. Now, this will be also connected with your Muladhara chakra. Then muscle spasm or any muscle tension or anything. Deep hurt that I've been, like, you know, stored and I'm not willing to release it. So once I go to the constitutional therapy of a person or a constitutional understanding of a person, I will find many such things that the person is holding, and he or she is aware or unaware. So it is... it's also a part of his or her unconscious mind. So unconscious mind is there in the present also, and it is coming back, coming from the soul also. So any which ways it can be treated. Okay, and the anger issues, again, it can be stored in your Muladhara chakra. It can be also in your Sahasrara chakra. So any which ways, whatever you are storing in your chakras, in your consciousness, is going to affect your body, because we are energy body finally. Okay. Then what consumes your mind controls your life. If you see, instead of having negative emotions of worry, stress, let's have these seven positive emotions that are very good for the heart. Laughter makes your blood flow more easily. Hugs release oxytocin and remove stress from the body. Spending time with the loved one lowers your blood pressure. And holding hand calms the nerves. A positive attitude lowers the risk of heart attack, and many, many more that will improve your life and cause the dis-ease to be in more harmony. And the pain that you feel in your body and in your life are the messengers. Always listen to them. When I started with the first slide, it said that listen, breathe, you know, hear, all of that will start when you regularly start spending time for your own self. And a divine communication happens always. The divine is always trying to communicate with you. Only sometimes a fine tuning is required. For some people, it will be more of fine tuning, because the patterns of rigidity of the soul, mind, and the emotional or a physical body are more rigid. So more tuning will be required. But some people, very less tuning, because energy is very, very good. Okay. So if you see this slide, there are three emotions that are being shown here. This is, she is expressing the emotional distress. Here she is little bit calm, she is little bit centered, but here she is more lightened up. If you see the smile, that is lightening up her aura. Okay, so we'll do a short technique here. We can I normally start my sessions with meditation. I have not done so. So we can be in a meditative pose. Don't cross your legs while meditating. And you can do it with your eyes closed. We just have to be for 2 minutes in a meditative state. Okay. And just smile. Now your smile can be this much like how she is. The more you smile, your aura and the light of your souls starts expanding. So we'll just close our eyes for 1 minute. आंखें बंद करनी है, आंखें बंद करके स्माइल. अगर आप मेडिटेशन पोस्ट में बैठना चाहते हो, ज्ञान मुद्रा, चिन मुद्रा, इट्स अप टू यू. आंखें बंद करनी है और स्माइल करना है. जस्ट फॉर अ सेकेंड स्माइल फॉर योर सोल. जस्ट फॉर अ सेकेंड स्माइल फॉर योर सेल्फ एंड स्माइल मोर. अलाउ योर स्माइल टू एक्सपांड लाइक अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड. अपने सांसों पे ध्यान देना. नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग करनी है. स्माइल. जितना एक्सपांड हो रहा है होने दो उसको एक्सपांड. डोंट स्टॉप इट. स्माइल. लेट योर टीथ शो. इट्स ओके. लेट योर आईज रेडिएट विद दैट ब्यूटिफुल स्माइल. इट्स ओके. स्माइल मोर. अलाउ योर लिप्स टू स्प्रेड मोर. स्माइल. एंड इन दिस स्टेट यू कैन ऑल्सो एक्सप्रेस ग्रैटिट्यूडनेस, thankfulness, and then slowly come back with a count of 1, 2, and 3. Slowly come back. Slowly open the eyes. You slowly open the eyes. How you feel? Good. This is the best therapy one can have. You don't need to learn from anyone. We've been using it since our childhood. Anything we want, first what we do is we smile. Okay? So it fits everyone's pockets. It's not a very expensive therapy. It's a gift that God has given to everyone. Smile itself is a key that fixes the lock of everyone's heart. Now, how much to smile, it's up to you. Okay? So don't say it's hard to smile, because it's as you deny your mind to feel happy or good. What do you, when you smile, how do you feel? Good, happy, right? Okay, so this is the best form of therapy that you can give to yourself. Keep smiling. And as you respect your own desires and boundaries, you know, and stop repressing them, you might experience increased energy and less anxiety and less stress. That means start spending time for your own self. Start, respecting your own boundaries. And there may be times you may have to say no to a certain thing, no to a negative pattern, no to a negative thinking. Because if you say so and if you create your boundaries, you will experience the less stress in the physical body, less stress in the mind, less of anxiety. Why do people are getting more into meditation and more into the forms of healing is because it's about connecting with your own self, and it's about being aware of your own strengths. So that itself will create more awareness and consciousness to heal your own self. So respect your own boundaries which are not good for you, and start experiencing this increased energy in whatever forms of healing or meditation that you do. But start spending time for yourself, and if you can change the thoughts of your consciousness, you can change the vibration of your body. Because it's a secret movie may we have seen thoughts become things. And we always say that thoughts become things. That means you whatever you want to attract, you create that form of consciousness inside you. You can, at any point, you can do that. It doesn't require a very hard effort. It's just a regular culturing is what is required for your mind. Then, now this is a very beautiful slide. It says that open mind is equal to creativity. Now, how are children? Their children are full of creativity and they have a lot of open mind. Now, all what I'm showing you as slides are building your mental, physical and emotional body. If you are aligned on these levels, the dis-ease in your body and the disharmony in your mind and body will be less. So, an open mind is equal to creativity. So, right now what we did was meditation plus smile. So, your mind becomes like a parachute. It is full of lot of creativity and creative solutions, and full of awareness and consciousness. Now, if you see this, both the slides are connected. I don't know if you can zoom and see. I got these slides yesterday only, but I did not know that, here it's written open mind is equal to creativity. I never knew that synchronistically I attracted this slide. It also says the open mind. It's just today I was trying to read what are these symbols. it is nothing but it's written as the open mind. So if I have an open mind, it's like a parachute. So it can get all my talents, it can help me to have a better emotional state and a more harmonious level. So this is what we need to balance, is our conscious mind, our subconscious mind, because whatever we see is stored inside, and all the decisions that we take are made on the subconscious level, because every storage happens here. So that's why it said that 10% we say as conscious mind and 90% we say as subconscious mind, and just below that we have another levels of mind which are unconscious, and in unconscious also there are many levels. And then again it said that the mind and the body are inextricably connected with our thoughts and emotions, exerting a powerful influence on our health. So it is very important to master our emotions, whichever way you do it, through EFT you do it, through Reiki you do it, through auric healing you do it, through meditation you do it, whichever way you do it. But it's very important to master which mask you want to wear. You want to wear this mask, or you want to wear this mask. So it's up to you, and you can change this mask at any time. But it's important to acknowledge that. So this is what I was wanting to say. Our mind is like a projector. This is exactly what is projecting, what you store. Become aware of the projector rather than being lost in the projection, rather than just being going. Just become aware. So that's how you will be connected with the divine flow. And this is also very beautifully written: to train the mind to move with the maximum speed and energy, with the utmost possible accuracy in the chosen direction, and with the minimal disturbance of frictions. That's the magic. You need to train your mind to move with the maximum speed and energy. That means our thoughts need to be aligned at that state. Continuously, whatever state we want to attract, it's a healthy state, it's a wealthy state, it's a balanced state, or it's a better emotional state for our balancing of our emotions in a relationship. In any which ways, you need to train the mind with the speed and energy, so that it is utmost possible accuracy in the chosen direction with the maximum disturbance and friction. That means you need to constantly monitor what is going inside the mind, and to stop the mind, and that is magic, to stop the mind altogether. Whatever is going in the mind, you need to be an observer to that. Okay, so this is how what will seen in the conscious mind will go inside, and from here it will be projected outside. So you feed inside and then it will be projected outside, and what it becomes later on, it becomes rigid patterns, it becomes a part of your unconscious mind. And again, unconscious mind itself has many layers. Okay, so this is how our personality shapes. We are not going to go more in the aura part. These are our different auric layers also, which also carry these energies of whatever we think, that will impact our emotional state, mental state and physical state. Many lectures have been given on this. I have also said a lot on the aura and chakras. So all that we will think, all that we will feel, all that we will see, and all that we will express will start shaping what we are in the forms of energy. So the cells in your body will react to everything that is in your mind, and it says that negativity will bring down your immune system. Okay, so smile more. Okay, this, I got this beautiful slide. It says that how to love yourself. This lecture is all about understanding and loving your own self, and seeing where I can change myself. First of all, stop criticizing yourself, and don't terrify your thoughts. Don't make your thoughts very full of fear and insecurities. You are a beautiful person, and you're divinely supported by God. God is the person who gives us everything, and we can nurture that and create many things out of that. And start saying loving things to yourself. That's very, very important. If you want to heal faster, please change your internal dialogue. And that ways any healing will be very fast. And be loving to your own self, and be loving to your negatives also, and find the need to take care of it. That means be very patient and kind with you. You are learning something new, and take care of your body. Very, very important is start loving yourself. Don't have the feelings of lack, because for God, you are His perfect child, and God will always love you like a small child. So don't have the feelings of lack, and start loving your own self. Don't criticize your own self. And again, these are the workshops that I have designed and courses that I have designed. And I again say, in whichever forms you take the coaching and learning, it's a very expensive gift that one should give. Whatever coaching and learning and consulting that you're doing, it's a one gift that you can gift yourself. Like I said, smile is one form of gift which doesn't, it's readily available. It was given as a gift to our soul when we were born. As if you see small children, they smile so much, but when we started growing up, our smiles only were happening when we were happy. But why can't we smile all the time? So coaching and learning and consulting is an expensive gift. One should gift self. And denying that, when we say that no, we don't want to learn, or you know, we don't want to do something, what's the use of doing this thing, why should we be doing this thing, that means we are denying ourselves an opportunity and we are disacknowledging the love one can give for the own selves. It's very important to learn new things and culture our minds in the right way, and also harness our mind. It's better to create a garden of mind rather than creating weeds, because weeds are going to disturb our consciousness, but a garden is going to create a beautiful fragrance, not just in my cells but also in my aura. So it's a beautiful way where one can acknowledge and give the gift in the form of knowledge, healing, curing, upgrading and structuring self and many more. So I think I've tried to cover many things, so thank you very much. And again, these are my numbers and this is my new email ID. And the website is not yet updated, so it would be the old one only. Maybe within 2-3 months it will have all the upgradation, because I'm coming up with new workshops. So this would soon have, but this is my email ID if you want to know anything, and this is my WhatsApp number, 9769293078. And again, I express a lot of gratitude and smile healings. Thank you very much.